Well, you see, I didn't want to get into politics by myself. You know, I didn't have a desire. I wasn't born into a political family. I wasn't educated into politics or anything like that. But when the opportunity came after Indira Gandhi died, and Rajiv Gandhi wanted me to contest, I was still very hesitant because I was scared. I just didn't know what it was all about. Then my father-in-law and my husband, late husband, both of them late now, they both encouraged me. Because we are a family of only just myself, my late husband, that's all the family was, and my parents-in-law. So there was nobody else to take my father-in-law's place. My husband was in the IAS, so he couldn't get into that. And even if he got into that, we had to stop him because who's going to earn the bread in the family? So I was the one who was chosen. I wasn't a committed politician or, you know, or a politician who wanted to be a politician. But circumstantially, I became one. Democratic politics. These are things which are bound to happen. And criticism sometimes is more vocal than, you know, appreciation or anything like that. I didn't feel let down. I thought that the party was giving it to somebody who didn't. I had never been to East Delhi, frankly speaking. I've always lived on this side of Delhi. So there was never an occasion for me to go to that side. So it was a totally alien place for me. I did resist it, I did say I don't know anything about it, but since it was a party mandate, I did it. And the central government and the home ministry and the police were really directly responsible for it. But it happened, but you know, sometimes you reach situations where you can't help, you just have to keep quiet because it is not wise to do it, and it's not courteous to do, you know, blame somebody else for what is considered as something that, you know, has happened in your city. Yes, I had gone to Jantar Mantar, and it was a fault of mine. I mean, it was not really a fault, actually. I would say it was courteous of me not to put the blame on others. Police is not under the Delhi government. So you see, but I did not say it. I did not say I didn't want to get out of it because the Chief Minister of Delhi is the face of Delhi. So if you try and give people excuses, say, you know, it's not with me, what can I do about it? Then I thought that it would be letting down the central government, letting down the police and letting us, and it wouldn't be a good, you know, proper thing to say. There's so many Nirbhayas happening these days. Nobody does anything about it. So it was politically motivated also. This is a very recent event, what you're talking of, Gaur Rakshaks and all. This is something which is being motivated, you know, it has a political angle to it. Fortunately, these things were not there. And thank God for no distractions of this kind. No. We have Congress all over the country and there's no coterie there. No, please. Yes, we do have a family in which all congressmen believe. And they have never let us down. What about the coterie of the Mr. Modi's and the Shah, Amit Shah's and all? They're all coteries there. So people do have this kind of thing. And to put the blame only on the Congress for this, or to put a blame, the word blame is wrong. It's a system, it's a style, which they have adopted just as much. Rahul Gandhi has become he was the vice president, he's from vice president, he's become the president. And it was a unanimous decision. It was a decision taken by the working committee and it was a decision by all congressmen who are members of the Congress. I don't say the supporters of the Congress, but all those who are members of the Congress who are eligible for casting a vote. Now, I want to ask if the party decides on a certain thing, why should anybody else object to it, number one, because nothing wrong was done. And it wasn't anything that was out of the way. But my son wanted it. He wanted to come into politics. And he said that, can I come? I was a little hesitant about it because I was already the chief minister here. And I was hesitant. I was hesitant because I didn't know whether Mrs. Sonia Gandhi would think it was the right thing to do, a mother asking for a son's ticket. But since he was keen, I picked up the courage, wrote to her and told her this. I must tell you, I felt very disappointed, and I still feel really disappointed. Because the Commonwealth Games, when they came out eventually in Delhi, were one of the best Commonwealth Games in the world. The government of India was a little apologetic about having accepted the Games. Why it had to be apologetic, I don't understand, because the whole face of Delhi changed after the Games were there. So everybody said, why are you spending so much money? Well, the money was going to be spent for Delhi. It wasn't just for the Commonwealth Games. I don't even want to think that I'm a bad man. But you see, being a woman politician has both its advantages and disadvantages. Its greatest disadvantage is a kind of a lack of confidence in a woman's capability and capacity to be able to fulfill what is required to be fulfilled. But on the other hand, there is also this feeling that here is a woman, she will understand much, she'll be more receptive. And frankly speaking, I'd like to ask you whether you have found any woman politician who has been a failure. You may lose an election, that's a different, you lose an, but no woman has been considered a failure. You know, whether it is Mamata Banerjee now or whether it is anybody else, women do live up to their expectations and are as adept at ruling as they are at anything else.